Hello and welcome back to Answering ATPL. In this ATPL question bank video series for general navigation subject, I'm going to show you how to solve this latitude question. Given waypoint 1, 60 degrees south, 30 degrees west, waypoint 2, 60 degrees south, 20 degrees west, what will be the approximate latitude shown on the display unit of an inertial navigation system at longitude 0 to 5 degrees west? The optional answers are A. 60 degrees 11 minutes south, B. 59 degrees 49 minutes south, C. 60 degrees 0 minutes south, and D. 60 degrees 6 minutes south. Whenever the question mentions inertial navigation system, it refers to a great circle flight. The location referred by this question is in the southern hemisphere. First, we need to draw the meridian line for waypoint 1 and waypoint 2. In the southern hemisphere, all meridian lines are converging toward the south pole. On the left is 30 degrees west longitude, and on the right is 20 degrees west longitude. Next, we need to draw the parallel of latitude, 60 degrees south. Parallel of latitude concave toward the nearer pole. Since the question is regarding great circle, we need to draw a great circle, represented by the green line on the screen. The question asks, what will be the approximate latitude shown on the display unit of an inertial navigation system at longitude 25 degrees west? Here is 25 degrees west longitude. The question asks us to find the latitude value of this position. The angle between the great circle and the rhumb line at initial and final position is known as conversion angle. From the data given by the question, we can calculate this angle using formula. Conversion angle equals half convergency. Conversion angle equal half times change of longitude times sine mean latitude. Change of longitude between waypoint 1 and waypoint 2 equals 30 degrees west minus 20 degrees west. Change of longitude equals 10 degrees. Since both waypoint lies on the same latitude, mean latitude equal 60 degrees. Now, we can plug in this value into conversion angle formula. Conversion angle equal half times 10 times sine 60. Conversion angle equal 4.33 degree. Next, we need to concentrate in the area within the dashboard. Departure is the length along a parallel of latitude. Thus, we can find the length of the red line. Departure equals change of longitude times 60 times cos latitude. The change of longitude between the two dashed line is 30 degrees west minus 25 degrees west. Change of longitude equal 5 degrees. The latitude is 60 degrees. Thus, departure equal 5 times 60 times cos 60. Departure equal 150 nautical mile. In order to solve the question, we need to transform this diagram into a right angle triangle. We need to find the value of the angle marked in yellow. The conversion angle is the angle between the great circle and the rhumb line. The start angle is 4.33 degrees. However, at the middle of the track, the great circle and rhumb line is parallel. Thus, the angle between the two is zero. Because of that, the angle marked by the yellow line is the average angle between the start and the middle point. The average angle equal 4.33 plus 0 divided by 2. The average angle equal 2.165 degree. We now have a right angle triangle. We can use trigonometry to find the length y. Sine theta equal opposite over hypotenuse. Sine 2.165 equal y over 150. Y equal 150 times sine 2.165. Y equal 5.67 nautical mile. Since 1 degree change of latitude equals 60 nautical mile, 1 minute change of latitude equals 1 nautical mile. Thus, 5.67 nautical mile equals 5.67 minute change of latitude. If we look at the overall diagram, great circle is further south than the rhumb line. Thus, the latitude shown at 25 degrees west equals 60 degrees south plus 5.67 minutes. Latitude shown at 25 degrees west equals 60 degrees 5.67 minutes south. The closest answer is D. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people to find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.